First this morning, Singapore and Lufthansa Airlines have joined Qantas in grounding their A380 fleets. It follows the emergency landing of a Qantas aircraft yesterday after one of its engines failed shortly after takeoff from Singapore. For more, we're joined now by TEN's John O'Doherty, who's at the Qantas base at Sydney Airport. John, now three airlines have grounded their A380s. What is the immediate effect on passengers?
Well, Ron, worldwide, there's going to be an enormous effect. Out of the three airlines that have now grounded their A380s, Lufthansa, Singapore Airlines and Qantas, Qantas has the smallest of the fleets. So worldwide, the effect is going to be enormous. There will no doubt be significant delays and cancellations will be inevitable. Airlines are trying to accommodate passengers where they can, either in hotels or on alternative flights, but the delays will no doubt be quite significant.
And how soon will we expect to see the passengers off that flight, QF32, back home?
Well, Qantas has now sent a replacement aircraft to bring those passengers back. It's due to depart Singapore later on this morning, so hopefully they'll be touching down in Sydney later on tonight.
A Qantas A380 pilot who's been grounded in London has just spoken about the incident. What did he have to say, John?
Well, Captain Barry Jackson is one of Qantas's senior A380 pilots. Now, he said that this is very surprising. He said, because the A380 is such a new fleet, the aircraft involved, the Nancy Bird Walton, it's only 2 years old. So he was very surprised at how this could even take place. Let's have a listen to what he had to say.
I think everyone's surprised at what's happened, particularly the nature of the failure and how extreme it was. The engines are designed to be to contain any sort of failure that may happen. So to see the visible damage to the engine was a surprise for everyone.
And Captain Jackson has also raised his concerns about Qantas's growing level of offshore maintenance in recent years. We've seen quite a significant increase in that. Here's what he had to say.
There's a proud history of maintenance and flight operations excellence in Qantas, and I'm pretty confident that certainly the Australian engineers will do a great job. I am concerned, as everyone, of outsourcing and offshoring. I have an opinion, I guess, that nobody looks after their own like their own.
Now, Qantas is due to celebrate its 90th anniversary tomorrow. This is certainly not the sort of thing that they would like to be dealing with at what should be a special time for them. Let's have a look back now at how the events unfolded yesterday.
Just minutes into flight QF32 from Singapore to Sydney, the crew was alerted to an engine problem. Remaining remarkably calm, the pilot informed passengers of the fault.
We have a technical issue with our number two engine. We have dealt with the situation at the moment. The aircraft is secure at this stage. We're going to have to hold for some time whilst we do lighten our load by dumping some fuel.
Passengers reported hearing two loud bangs as one of the A380's Rolls-Royce engines exploded, shooting flames and raining large metal chunks onto the ground below.
It was a bit almost like a bomb sound, and some people reported that they thought it's in a flash.
After dumping fuel, the pilot made an emergency landing at Singapore's Changi Airport. All 433 passengers and 26 crew on board safe at last.
But only when we stepped off the aircraft did we really see. You know, we looked under the aircraft, you could see the back end of the engine.
Authorities say more than 100 pieces of debris were found on the Indonesian island of Batam, damaging at least six homes. Qantas has grounded its six Airbus A380s until the cause of the mid-air drama is known.
Rolls-Royce and Airbus are looking at the issue. They're working with our people to understand what we believe could be the cause of it.
The last Qantas Super Jumbo, still airborne, landed in Los Angeles early this morning. For now, it's not going anywhere. Singapore Airlines and Lufthansa have also delayed their fleets of the aircraft. Passengers from QF32 will begin arriving in Sydney on other flights today. Kate Creedon, 10 News.
The mid-air emergency has dampened celebrations for the 90th anniversary of Qantas tomorrow, as John just reported. We were scheduled to speak with Qantas Chief Executive Alan Joyce, but he's since pulled out of that interview. Instead, we're joined now by Qantas spokesperson Olivia Wirth. Olivia, good morning to you. You'll be getting first reports back from engineers on the ground in Singapore. Have they been able to at least closely identify exactly what happened to that explosion in that engine yesterday?
At this stage, we don't have exact reports on what has happened. As you've indicated, Ron, we've worked overnight with our engineers, with those engineers from Rolls-Royce and also Airbus to exactly find out what has occurred. Until we have such confidence in the fleet, we will not be operating our A380 aircraft.
You've got literally billions of dollars invested in your A380 fleet, and now two other airlines have joined you in grounding their fleets. What does this mean for the future of this particular aircraft?
We do have six aircraft in our A380 fleet. As you've indicated, Singapore and Lufthansa have also grounded their fleet. At this stage, we are trying to determine what went on, and once we're confident with that, we will get our A380 back in the air.
One of the pilots actually grounded with the Qantas fleet in London, Captain Barry Jackson, spoke to 10 News overnight, expressing his concerns about outsourcing maintenance. Now, in light of the string of incidents involving Qantas planes in recent times, isn't it time Qantas brought home all its major maintenance operations?
Ron, there's a lot of misinformation out there about our maintenance of our aircraft.
Oh, Olivia, hang on. Now, this is a Qantas pilot. He was one of the pilots on an A380. He is saying it's time to bring it home. It's not about misinformation.
It's actually not possible, Ron. We actually have 85% of our maintenance, which is done onshore. 85% of our maintenance is done within Australia. We operate aircraft internationally, therefore we do need to have maintenance lines in Singapore because we run aircraft through Singapore, also Los Angeles and London. Over the last 10 years, maintenance in Australia has been at 85%. In fact, last year, it was 92% of all maintenance of Qantas aircraft done in Australia. We have 5,500 engineers. They are very well qualified, and we will continue to do a vast majority of our maintenance here in Australia.
What does the grounding of the A380s mean for Qantas passengers, both now and until the fleet is back in the air?
Obviously, there are many passengers who have been inconvenienced. QF32 passengers arrived back into Sydney this evening. We ran an additional 747 flight. They'll touch down here tonight. We have also grounded four other A380 flights which were due to fly out of Los Angeles, Melbourne and also Sydney today. We'll be getting them on alternative arrangements as soon as we can, and if they have been misplaced, we'll be providing them with accommodation, meals and also calls back to family and friend, and of course providing them with updates on the possible situation and delays.
Now Olivia, it's so unfortunate that this incident of course has overshadowed the 90-year celebration of Qantas. Under the circumstances, how will you go ahead with the celebrations tomorrow?
Well, obviously, Qantas has been operating for 90 years. You did indicate that before. Tomorrow, we have John Travolta, who is a Qantas ambassador at large. He will touch down in Sydney, and we will continue to carry on with our celebrations of 90 years. It's a long service. We're proud of it, and we've always put safety first. We have announced we're grounding our A380 service. Safety is part of who we are at Qantas, and we will continue to celebrate the airline and its success record over the past 90 years.
Good on you, Olivia. Thank you very much.
Thanks,
Worth there, a spokesperson for Qantas, talking with us live.